Hello, I'm Amy Ludwig Vanderwater, an author and teacher from Western New York. Welcome to Keeping a Notebook. This is the outside and the inside of Betsy the Writing Camper, home of Keeping a Notebook. 2020 is my 11th year of writing a poem each day of National Poetry Month. I always write around a different theme. For this year's poetry project, I have decided to introduce surprise. Each April day, I will share a poem's can phrase about writing poetry. I will roll 3-word dice. If a die rolls blank, I will not re-roll it. I will write a poem inspired by 1, 2, or all 3 of the face-up words. Today's Roll the Dice poetry chat is titled Poems Can Include Facts.
Let's roll those dice with 1, 2, and 3. We have clear, wild, travel. Clear, wild, and travel.
Hello, poetry friends. It is day 39 of Keeping a Notebook, day 27 of National Poetry Month. I am very happy you're back. Big high five. Thank you for joining me and Betsy for another day of writing together. And today's poetry chat is titled Poems Can Include Facts. We have talked before about how a poem can tell a story in its lines. A poem might be a list. A poem can give advice. And it is also true that poems can include facts. So if I'm writing a poem about a time in history, certainly I would include facts. Or about an important person, I would include facts. About a place, I would include facts. So today we think about how poems can include facts. And our words are, and you'll notice repeat, clear, wild, and travel. So clear, wild, travel, we're thinking about fact. I'm still thinking about the characters in my little story, Antoinette, Gloria, Sonata, and the new fledgling Robin, who I named today, which was sort of fun to think about. So here are the words. Here are my notes. I jotted clear, things that are clear, clear water, clear stream, clear head. There's a clearing up ahead, kind of like a grass plain, wild, not domestic, a free feeling, not holding back. Travel to go somewhere. So I jotted, what if Antoinette had not met her friends? Should they, and then I don't know where my thinking went here, but should they cheer on fledgling Robin? Antoinette travels by paw. What if her friends met to cheer on another friend? And then I wrote, wild afternoon, a small wild bird. Fledgling Robin's name is Walter. How did I know that? But then it isn't Walter. Now it's Wesley. I had some name play here. So I jotted words that start with W, wild, willing, wonderful. That's how I ended up with Fledgling Robin's name. I wanted it to start with a W because of wild. I thought I might do a little wordplay with those, but I ended up really with fact. I had to look up the fact in this poem. And when you hear me read, you'll say, oh, that's the fact. So this poem is titled Encouragement, and I will read it to you best I can. 3 old friends stand in a clearing beneath a pussy willow tree. One new friend at flying calls out, hi there, look at me. Every day for 13 days, 3 friends cheer and clap. And one day, fledgling Wesley Robin looks and leaps and flaps. So that is the day he learns to fly. And the fact, of course, was 13 days. And that's about the amount of time that a little robin will be in the nest before, poof, off it goes into learning to fly. So today we are thinking how poems can include facts. They don't need to include facts. They don't need to tell a story. A poem can do whatever it is you wish, but you can. If you fall in love with a particular fact or you're very fascinated by something, you can say, I'm going to use that fact in my poem. So I thank you for coming back. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. I cannot believe we just have 28, 29, and 30 left in National Poetry Month. I'm going to miss these little critters. So we'll see. Maybe I'll still write about them down the line. But good to see you again. You take good care of yourself, and I'll see you soon.
It took me a little while to figure out what to do with today's words and writing technique, but I loved learning that it takes a baby robin about 13 days to leave the nest. Antoinette, Glorious, and Sonata are encouraging fledgling Wesley Robin today. What good pals they are. Today's words are clear, Wild and travel. Our friends are standing in a clearing. Little Wesley is doing something wild as he learns to travel the sky. Thank you for traveling with me this far. It's day 27 of National Poetry Month. I can't even believe it. Take care.